one is pretty much my affirmation piece, because oftentimes in social justice work, we lose our own feeling of love for ourselves, and we get hurt often sometimes where this work is not easy. And so I was once called, I was an extraordinary, and that hurt me. So this was my response to that, this piece, and I wanted to dedicate it to all of you who went through these weeks of training and learning. And then I added a piece to a tribute to all of you towards the end, so it's like a two-in-one piece. And this is a poem to remind us to continue being our unapologetic selves no matter what. So this is for all of you. I am everything but extraordinary. According to the world that defines me to be anything but me. Walk into a room and already they assume my identity, not knowing the complexities that stem from a people's antiquity, rooted past DNA down to the gist of who I be. I refuse to be a pixel picture perfect person you want me to be, cause I be my motherland's tongue, coming in a sword to distant shores. I stand on some father's fourscores and 600 years of Gettysburg never addressed. My fathers and mothers that fought wars to be free, leaving out our true people's history, never written in the school books that have claimed to be who I be. I be my own story, jotted into a journal entry. Sometimes a blank page or a scribble in a scratch is the poem that I be. Sometimes ink blotted, the eyes dotted, rolling off the tongue like vectored splashes, I leave it all spotted. These are the words I describe me. Even with my belly twisted, twirly, tummy untucked and knotted, I be. I be fierce like my mama holding me in my arms. I be liberated like Lorena shouting Maki Baka from here to Pico Farms. I be that real hip hop star. My rhymes rock steady like Mozart. I rock gold earrings cause I be girl B, and I do it for the art. We be what we was born to do, because we are a descendant of storytellers and we write stories for people in the dark. We spark because writing is a struggle against silence. We be taking small steps, but we scream like a giant. We be defiant, fish chanting, causing riots through song. And in beat, we stop the violence. We be in pain and in joy, in day and in night, in verse and in hook, in bridge and in tune, in rhythm and in rhyme, in hip hop. And in pen, we be with love. Love is all the answer I need to be fully free. I find it extraordinary when society labels me, puts us in boxes so that I can't be me, categorize me, circle me, checks box me. I be driving down South Bay to La Vista checkpoint. Somehow they always find a way to corner us. Roll down your window, check. Driver's license, please, check. No drugs in there, check. No alcohol, check. No weapons, check. You can move along now. You can take your flight now, unless you're Dr. David Dow on United Airlines. You can move forward now. You can move past go now. You are American now. You are free for now. You are extraordinary for now. We be everything extraordinarily, eloquently, elegantly, ecstatically, quintessentially plain. I be, and we be the simple little yellow daffodil on your windowsill. We be that cocoon turned butterfly, free will like a quill, inked with goodwill. We are sealed and we are filled in shapes and tones and colors you've never seen before. I be adored by the people's matters to me most, from the east to the west coast, from the toast to the most high, because I am thankful to be alive. I have survived my father's death, seeing how all the men who have beaten me, raped me, and left, drank OEs, drugged up to forget all the hurts, and still I have no regrets. Even when my mom, sis, and I went broke and homeless, even when I was 10 years old in the middle of the night, he put his hands on me and placed threat, then me in a misery full of financial debt. While the police pull up, we out here in the sweat, marching in every action to survive Trump's administration and nuclear threats. It's been a long time since I've seen the sunset, and yet we still continue to stand strong till our last breath. I be the best of me. I be wearing t-shirts, sweatpants, hair up, no makeup except today. I still look the best out of luck. Chalk these deuces up to those who pass this buck. I be that woman who sometimes don't give. Fashion Mag CEO's vision of extraordinaire, but we dare to be better than that. We be the scat to a fat cat, give down to those who give a chance to know where this love is at. We will not be a doormat, so they best get through this format, because we are not programmed to be like the rest of them, because we be the poem to their head. We be spread like the wings to our soul. We be whole and we be incomplete. We be street when we have to give love, because the world needs to have more of me and you. You are my revolution. You are my truth within. With you I breathe in generations and generations of our people's story, your story, our people's story, because known blood thick and sewn into this brown skin of mine, this skin of yours, beautiful, maganda, maganda. I still sit painting in your view because of you my reflection is new. Because of you I now know the world. I now know that this is for me. What becomes a revolutionary without this use? You leave me speechless because your chants are raising fists for every wish I ever dreamed to be fully free. I can sleep better knowing that you're out there fighting for me, living for me, struggling for me, for it can't ever mean a thing without you, Kasama. Sometimes it feels like there's no end, and it feels like we're alone, like they don't ever understand, won't ever know or see. I know this feeling too well, but yet you live on. You live on and you march on. And I'm inspired by both your vulnerability, resistance, and resiliency in your will. And because of you, I know that I will continue to move with you, for you, beautiful, gifted warriors. You are our revolution. You are our truth within. And because of you, we are able to breathe it all in and be the revolution for you too. Thank you for all that you do. You, revolutionary, extraordinary you. Thank you.